All right, tonight on this stage here, we are pleased to announce Vivian Campbell and friends. Let's give it up. We'll be right back.
you. Thanks much. Oh, God. I couldn't begin to tell you how nervous I am about playing a GIT. Because, you know, it's kind of an intimidating thing. Anyway, I'll try not to fuck up too much. Sorry, I probably shouldn't have said that either. This is a song by Jimi Hendrix called Little Wing. You like Hendrix, huh? Yeah, me too. I'm going to do another one of those. Miller time. Yeah. Yeah, I'm pretty fond of Hendrix. So we're going to do Purple His for the hell of it. Anybody have any questions? Or, you know, this is supposed to be somewhat of a give and take kind of vibe, you know. So if anybody wants to know anything about how I managed to play so bad or how much my gear cost, feel free to ask, because those questions I can easily answer. But if you don't, fine. Yes, sir. We're just mixing it this week. It'll be out October 1st. Should be good. Louis Gritz name. Keith Olsen. Yo. Man, I love Rory Gallagher. I'm going to do a Rory Gallagher tune real soon. Yeah, Rory was the first guitar player that I ever saw play live, because he was one of the only guys who would ever come and play in Belfast where I live. And he used to play there every Christmas. And he just put on a great show. He's a great live player, you know, and his live albums are always his better albums, because he just really captures that. And above all else, he's a wicked slide guitar player. I mean, just razor, you know. So, yeah, we're always a big influence on me. I saw Gary Moore play a couple times with Thin Lizzy, and I've seen him once on his solo thing. He's an intense guitar player. Real intense. Matter of fact, I learned a lot of my bad habits from Rory Gallagher and Gary Moore, because they both, Rory in particular, you know, picks really, really hard. So does Gary. And they mostly pick a lot of downstrokes, I find. So when those two guys were my biggest influences when I was learning how to play. And so I'd be picking, and all the time I was playing with Dio and stuff, I was only ever doing, you know, down picks. I'd never do up picks. So I used to get cramps in my arms and shit. It's about 10 inches. Why don't you ask your girlfriend? She can draw you a picture. Yo! Ouch, babe. Ouch. So, yeah. But I tell you, I learned a lot of bad habits from those guys that I've tried to break. And the one thing, you guys are probably watching me on the screen here saying he never picks. I don't really pick very much. I play a lot of legato stuff. And I really am trying to pick, but for years I only picked downstrokes, and it's a real hard habit to break, and I'm trying to... In fact, maybe you guys could clue me in on this. I often wonder, when I'm doing double picking, should it be wrist movement or should it be thumb and... Okay, all those who think it's wrist, raise your hand. And all those who go for this thingy... One, two, three... Okay, I think I'll try it with the wrist thing. Because I never know, I mean, because I see different people do it. And but thanks for the tip. So, I think I'm going to tune up. Give me 1 minute. We can continue to have intimate conversation while I tune. Yes. Split harmonics? Well, that's another Rory thing, you know, and that's another habit to break, because I really got into playing a lot of split harmonics before I knew any licks and just trying to make the sound. So, you know, to do it, you got to pretty much attack it, you know. And it's a pretty aggressive thing, and it's a hard habit to break. I do it too much when I listen to my own playing. Like when I'm making a record and I do a solo, I go back and I listen to it and I'm thinking, you know, instead of hitting natural notes, I hit a bunch of harmonics, and it kind of pisses me off. I've really got to keep myself in check about that. But... you guys could probably tell me a lot more about split harmonics than I could tell you. All I know is I like the way they sound. So I don't know what causes them or how it affects the Earth's axis or anything like that. It just, or who gives a fuck. It's just something I do. Superstition. Stevie Wonder. We don't know how to end this, by the way, so, you know, bear that in mind. You'll be seeing a lot of confused faces. Michael! We'll try that again, thank you.
Wash
your face and hands. Let him know the problem. Do all that you can. You keep me in a daydream, yeah. Keep me holding on. And I wanna save me. So sad is my song. Superstition made the way. Thanks. Hey, forgive my singing, I'm only learning. I want to do a song now by a band called Tin Lizzy, who are a very fine bunch of Paddies. And, you know, they were a big influence on me. And this is a song called Don't Believe a Word, but not the version you know. No, it was a different version of this. No, I won't go into the other part. This is a bastardized version. Because it's kind of got... Fuck, my battery just ran out. Anyone got a 9-volt? 9-volt battery? No? Okay, well, let me see what's happening here. Don't believe it, Tori.
if I tell you, especially if I tell you, I'm in love with you. Don't believe me if I tell you that I wrote this song for you. There just might be some other silly pretty girl I'm singing it to. Don't believe a word. Words can tell lies, and those lies are no comfort when tears are in your eyes. Promise made to be broken. Oh, don't believe me if I tell you, not a word of this is true. Don't believe me if I tell you, especially if I tell you I'm in love with you. Oh, don't believe a word.
Makes me want to cry. So emotional now. Don't believe a word. He is. Phil Lynott was a great guy. I did some work with Phil Lynott right before he died. Unfortunately, it was never released. Probably just as well. It wasn't that good. Nah, he was pretty fun. Cheers. Here's to everything in moderation. Yeah, let's go concert. In case any of you are wondering where the keyboard player is. He's in my EH3000. It's a program called Crystal Echoes. It's kind of like a chorus program that has a heavy regen on it and kind of feeds into each other. It goes, as you'll hear if I hit one note. And therefore creates a chorus effect. Anyway, I'm going to change my guitar, put on my Les Paul, and we'll do something. I can't believe in a guitar school they don't have any guitar stands. That's because you bastards keep stealing them. That's what they told me anyway. So it's a crying shame. Does anyone have a Marlboro Red? If I won't haul out of smokes, and I'd really like one very, very much. No? Good lad. Right, well, I got the smoke. I just need a match, and we're having them. Oh, you got a match? You guys heard all the Pee-wee jokes? Like he fired his defense attorney because he figures he can get himself off, you know? All right, okay. What's the other one? The guy in Milwaukee, this is pretty sick. I mean, because someone, you know, he's a pretty sick individual, but they let him out on bail, but it cost him an arm and a leg, apparently. You know. So then he gets home, right, and he figures his apartment's too small because he needs more elbow room. So he gets a bigger... Oh! Ow!
bucks, babe.
Okay, I'm not a comedian. I'm barely a guitar player, so let's rock. A very good friend of mine from Dublin, Ireland, a guy by the name of Dave King is going to come out and sing a couple songs with us. He has here in his hand, Spot the Irishman. He brings his own. Lovely. Dave, you're a fucking star. A total fucking star.
Honey and lemon, my balls. Miller Lite. What are we doing?
We're almost ready to do a tune here. I just had to tune up the concert.
Are you in concert? You ready, Don? Huh?
Hey, hey, mama, is it the way you move? Gonna make you sweat, gonna make you groove. Yeah. Ah, child, the way you shake that thing, gonna make you burn, gonna make you sing.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Dave King, for your listening pleasure.
Yeah. Listen, Johnny, the reason why he asked me down here is because he helped me move my furniture to my new apartment. So, Vivian, on behalf of myself and my girlfriend, who you know so well.
She's nice.
Oh, she's great.
She's a grand little girl.
You're a gentleman and a scholar. And a fine judge.
And an acrobat who used to rake it in paper. Anyway.
What are we going to do now?
I don't.
What? Okay, you want me to do the last line? Okay, here's a quick impression. Rest in line! Ready?
I can't remember any Dave songs. Maybe if you paid me more, I might have been able to remember. You pay peanuts to get monkeys, you know.
The what?
You pay peanuts to get monkeys.
Right. Right. Are you right? Shapes of Things. For being two sons of Ireland. Anyway, by the way, there's a bass player and drummer here, isn't there?
Yes.
Chris Isaacs on bass guitar.
Isn't that James Dean?
Who?
James Dean.
James Dean.
Or Chris Isaac. One of this is Kurt on bass.
This guy had hair down to his arse 2 days ago. Then his arse cut up for his head. Anyway, on drums. From Italy, from Detroit, Italy. Michael Onzo. Is that his grandma over there? Is that his grandma over there? And this is a song by...
I'm gonna really focus these words.
A song by the greatest living Irishman that ever walked the face of the earth. You knew my son, and so did he. What's this? Jailbreak by Thin Lizzy. You won't be doing that after you hear it. No, you won't. It'll be marks out of 10. The Big E? Oh, the Big E. I hope the Black Pearl of Ireland will be proud of that one.
Oh, gee.
I've got to go to a party after this. That's why I'm dressed like a dickhead, you know?
You look a bit like a Nazi, Dave. Like a brown shirt.
Uncle Alston!
Sorry. Well, being immigrants to the great country of America, being two Paddies, you and me, bud, let's do the immigrant song, eh?
What is it?
Barry.
One more time, Barry.
Festive
mood tonight.
We see, I'm meant to be at this premiere of a movie, darlings, you know. And here I am, up here, with a giddy eye. Speaking of Irishman,
would that be
good old Rory Gallagher, eh? Just like Rory Gallagher, yeah?
Somebody asked me
about
mother, so somebody must know.
Hey, come here. I mean, I'm just here. I don't... Is there a department in the school for singers?
Yeah.
Anybody Vince, singers? Who's the singers? Oh, Jesus. Where's
There's
the
one.
Hands?
There's one.
Where?
Right there.
Oh, yeah. Do you know messing with the kid? Messing with the kid? No?
No.
Oh, we're fucked now.
His girlfriend. Yo! Let's do it.
I call a master with a key. so it's a kiss. Hey, you can call it what you want. I call it ass with a kiss.
Right down, right down.
Messing with the kid, messing with the kid.
To another.
Ah.
What? What? Come on, babe, get the battery going. I don't care about 9 volts and things like that.
Sense just paint it red and I can land anything, you know?
What are we doing? Oh, what's the beginning of, a Hector system? Hector. We've done 4 already, but... Yeah. We've done 4 already, but now we're steady. And then they went.
Singing
na 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 na. Robert. Na 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 na.
Lovely.
Sitting around singing songs till the night turns into day. You should sing to the mountains, but the mountains washed away. Now I'm singing all my songs to the girl who won my lot. She's the only free in song, but it's a real fine way to start.
Every singer's nightmare, a mic stand.
Sorry, Mike.
Ah, you gotta laugh, don't you? Jesus. Yeah.
Our last song, and then we're gonna saw it off. So, be cool.
What?
What'd he say?
Pray for it.
Oh. Okay, be right there. Isn't that Freebird?
Come on. Yeah.
Bless, take care.
Thank you very much.
This is Viviana Campbell on the guitar. No excuse for playing.
Thank you. That is alcohol abuse.
Another dead soldier.
Don't worry.
The reason why I'm drinking is because I'm not a boring part and I've really got to be like in the mood for it. But I tell you what, why don't we have a bit of a party here?
We didn't really plan for this because we didn't think that anyone would want anymore, so we're... What?
Bye.
That's all I know.
Let me ask you a question. Do you know the lyrics? Huh?
Going around.
Come on, let's get up and shake our asses here, yeah?
Thank you.
It's about... Now there's a singer.
Thank you.